things and think about transport. Used to identify what is crash core consists of and to identify how to arrange crash core conducts according to policy of the hospital and to determine role of nurse during checking on the crash core. And the outline, definition of the crash core, history of the crash core, policy about the crash core and the arrangement of crash core. And this is the thing with the crash core at the top where you are seeing that is the defibrillator and the nearby we are supposed to see the multiple cardiac monitor and make sure it is charged. And the definition of crash cart, it's a mobile collection of emergency equipment and supplies in a single place in order to make sure in the time of the resuscitation. And it includes both equipments like defibrillator, intubation items and all intravenous medication and the passage of central lines. And here you can see that the crash cart contain various side tracks and at the bottom it has some wheel so that easy we can transport from one place to another. And the crash cart should be kept in an easily accessible position which is central to the patient care areas. The history of crash cart. In 1962, Badani Medical Centers, that the crash cardiac cart was first introduced, and initially it was called as a cardiac cart, and it was initiated or functioned by the team called the Code Blue team. And this is the thing with the crash cart at the top, where you are seeing that is the defibrillator, and the nearby we are supposed to see the multiple cardiac monitor and make sure it is charged. And in 1967, the nurse Anita Dore emergency nursing crisis cart, and when she was working in the emergency department, she realized that it is better to have a crash cart. That is the equipment totally it's needed for both cardiac and respiratory treatment so that if it's accessible in a single place, it will be very useful for the patients. So, with the fellow nurses to compile a list of emergency response medications, supplies and equipments that enlisted in the emergency nursing crisis cart. So it was introduced in the year 1967. Coming to the policy of the crash cart, the first, the crash cart should be placed in an easily accessible specific location, and the location of the crash cart should be posted, that is it should be posted on the crash cart on the wall. And the outline, definition of the crash cart, history of the crash cart, policy about the crash cart and the arrangement of crash cart. And ensure the defibrillator is charged regularly and check for battery backup by the nursing officer. And the crash cart items, all the items should be checked as a routine basis of every Saturday of every month, the first Saturday of every month for expiry drugs. And the common thing, better before 3 months of expiry, we have to notify to the pharmacy and change the drug and replace. And this check includes sterilization dates of consumables like ET tubes, suction tube, etc. And it should have a B-type oxygen cylinder. So the B-type oxygen cylinder, the capacity is 10 liter. This door worked with the fellow nurses to compile a list of emergency response medications, supplies and equipments that enlisted in the emergency nursing crisis cart. So it was introduced in the year 1967. To identify what is crash cart consists of and to identify how to arrange crash cart conducts according to policy of the hospital and to determine role of nurse. Airway equipment such as bag, wall, nurse, oral and nasal airways, oxygen mask and cannulas IVIO assess equipment including angiocats, IV tubing and fluid, and iotril and needles. Iotril is nothing but it is used for intraosseous infusion, and it is the process of injecting the products directly into the marrow of the blood. And plus medication like for cardiac arrest, epinephrine and amiodarone, and for cardiac dysrhythmia, adenosine, diltiazem, beta blocker and atropine, and for allergic reactions, epinephrine, methylprednisolone, and diphenhydramine, and for myocardial infarction, aspirin and nitroglycerin. And this check includes sterilization dates of consumables like ET tube, suction tube, etc. And it should have a bead type oxygen cylinder. So the bead type oxygen cylinder, the capacity is 10 liter. Here you can see the seven steps of the crush cord. First, we have to set up the crush cord in a proper place. That is the place, and the cord should be checked in every shift of the nurses, and the port blue will be started functioning. Initiate the port blue, then treat the patient, record or documentation, and again we have to restore the syringe as possible. First, setup and configuration. So cord should be outfitted with all the appropriate emergency care medication, supplies and equipments. It should be organized as per hospital policy. To the history of crush cord, in 1962, Bethany Medical Centers, the crush cardiac cord was first introduced, and initially it was called as a cardiac cart, and it was. And the definition of crush cord, it's a mobile collection of emergency equipment and supplies in a single place in order to make sure in the time of the code initiation, once the code is initiated, the team members of the code blue will be rushed to the patient. They will take the crush cord. So when they are shifting the crush cord, make sure you are unplugged. If it has that cardiac monitor or the defibrillator, it should be unplugged because to avoid accidents or damage. And the crush cord should be secured and organized in the way that support rapid mobility. And the fifth, the coming to the patient care, patient must be able to assess all resources and reference sheets quickly and easily during the court response to ensure the patient get the care they need the instant they need it. And this is the thing on the crush cord on the top where you are seeing that is the defibrillator, and the nearby we are supposed to see the multiple cardiac monitor and make sure it is charged. Restocking. So restocking is nothing but the replenishment as soon as possible, as early as possible, because we may need in use of crash cord in any other situation. So once the cord is restored, the cycle begins anew with the placement. And plus medication like for cardiac arrest, epinephrine and amiodarone, and for cardiac dysrhythmia, adenosine, diltiazem, beta blocker and atropine, and for allergic reactions, epinephrine, methylprednisolone, and diphenhydramine, and for myocardial infarction. And the medication, so commonly we will keep the medication on the top drawer because it should be assessed very quickly in need of available situations. So the medication provided in a way that make easy to measure and dispense quickly. Used to identify what is crush cord consists of and to identify how to arrange crush cord condoms according to policy of the hospital and to determine role of nurse during checking. This door worked with the fellow nurses to compile a list of and lidocaine, it's lidocaine 2 gram and 100 mg. Provide an iodine swab stick and vasopressin 20 units. And the crush code even also contain the pediatric medications in the second trial, like injection atropine 0.5 milligram, sodium bicarbonate 10 milligram, saline flush syringes, and sodium chloride 0.9%. And the second trial of crush code might also contain the saline solution in order to dilute any medication. So the saline solution from antemortal to 1 liter pass. And even intubation set also will be present in order to perform intubation. So the intubation set usually we will keep in third and fourth trial. And the second trial of the crush cord might also contain saline solution of various sizes from 100 milliliter to 1 liter. And intubation set that the intubation glide of various sizes, that is large, medium and small, that is laryngoscope, and all the intubation set will be available. To the history of crush cord, in 1962 Badani Medical Centers, that the crush cardiac cord was first introduced, and initially it was called as a cardiac cart, and it was initiated or functioned by the team called the Code Blue team. Then stillet, bite block, tongue pressure. Newer setup include materials needed to start quantitative waveforms. And ensure that defibrillator is charged regularly and check for battery backup. And the fifth, the coming to the patient care, clinician must be able to assess all resources and reference sheets quickly and easily during the code response to ensure the patient get the care they need the instant they need it. And the disposable Macintosh, lights, arm boards of various sizes, vacutainers for blood collection, and spinal needles in order to take any fluid for any investigation, and suction catheters of various sizes, bone marrow needles of various sizes. And even the feeding tubes, umbilical vessel catheter, disinfectant, swabstick and pediatric IV kits. And intravenous line to start, intravenous line, separate drawer will be meant to keep all the IV lines set and the micro and macro set tubing. And the IV drawer usually contain IV start kit, angiocatheters, 14 gauze, 16 gauze, and all the disinfectants, lower lock syringes of various sizes, tonic kit, and inside auto guards of various sizes and vacutainers for blood collection. And in 1967, the nurse sanitor door emergency nursing crisis card. And coming to the policy of the crush cord, the first, the crush cord should be placed in an easily accessible specific location. And the location to the history of crush cord, in 1962, Badani Medical Centers, that the crush cardiac cord was first introduced, and initially it was called as a cardiac cart, and it was initiated or functioned by the team called the Code Blue team. Any case, the following kit may be found in the procedure drawer. That is, we will keep the procedure drawer ECG electrodes, steroid gloves of various sizes, sutures of various sizes, suction supplies, saline pump, cricothyroidectomy kit, adult and pediatric cutdown pack. And the crush cord even also contain the pediatric medications in the second trial, like injection atropine 0.5 milligram, sodium bicarbonate 10 milligram, saline flush syringes, and sodium chloride 0.9. And the definition of